Happy Mom's Truth Friday.
Two moms in the city.
In a car, drinking some wine, because everyone else bothers us everywhere else. So if you want to join us in the car, you just join us.
I'm not allowed to drink in the car.
I'm not. I'm just not moving. You know what? No one knows what this is. This is a set.
We don't actually even have our driver's license.
Exactly. So it just really dawned on me. That word bothers me. Hit me.
I'm holding the fire. Careful.
Oh, Jesus. It just really behooved me. It really hit me like a ton of bricks. Is that women, especially in this time, are the emotional trampoline of the entire family.
That includes the animals that live in your house, by the way.
That's everybody.
Speaking of, I don't think we fed the fish since we got the dog.
Jeez.
That fish is going to die and then I'm going to be the emotional trampoline.
Exactly. You can't cry. You know what? You can't cry. Mm. You have to find the bright side of the fish, tonne. You've got to talk about the circle of life. If you are just exhausted of being the emotional trampoline for everybody, you got a long way to go.
I mean, just think about it. We've been the emotional trampoline for these 7 months, but then we're going to have to be the emotional trampoline for when everybody else transitions back to school and work and all that.
Oh, yeah, or if you go into your basement for virtual learning, you are looking forward to that being over. No, you're back in the house for another X amount of months. You got to be happy for them for that, but you're not happy.
Everything's fine.
Yeah, I don't have a life. I do. I cook 1,700 meals a day. I do laundry all day. I try to work full time all day, and I got to be all day.
When they cry because they're going back to school and they haven't been there in so long, they have such anxiety that they don't know how to handle it. You're going to be the ones up with them in the night. You're going to be the one when they can't go to sleep. You're going to be one in the morning trying to coerce them to go to school. And you're going to be
just going to bribe them.
What do I have left? I've bribed them with everything.
Okay, I got this. If your emotional trampoline is so stretched,
yeah,
at this point, like saggy. Like there's not even a bounce left. People have bounced on you so hard,
yeah.
And I'm not even talking about your vagina. I am strictly talking about right now just the emotional world of life. Screen time, free pass. Snacks, free pass.
Sick of snacks and screen time.
I'm like, get a life. And
I
they're
am,
like,
seriously,
I can't get a life. I have nowhere to go. I'm like, it's time to get your own. I have my life. It's time for you to get a life.
And I'm trying to get my life back in order. So can you go back to school?
We are trying to get a bit of spring in our step and we can't because the emotional trampoline is so empty.
I'm like a waterbed.
It's pretty springy, actually.
No, it's not. Don't dare jump on a waterbed.
It'll pop.
You know, I feel like I wish there was some sort of like a spa or like a rehab the kids had to go to for 1 week before they went back to school.
Mm. Boot camp.
And also get them not so used to us all the time. Mm. And you know, they can start emotionally trampling off of other people and each other and their own selves.
You know what? They can start self-regulating. It's time to put your big boy pants on. I don't care if you wear underwear. Get out the f***ing door and deal with life. They need to launch out the door.
We've been doing this for far too long.
I know. Why does everyone else get feelings but us as moms? Why are we the only ones without feelings?
You know, I literally heard on the news today that COVID has hit women the hardest.
That's not even news. That's called facts. Factually speaking, women have been holding the ship together.
Do our partners realize this?
I mean, men think it's hit them. They think they have a hard time, but they're not a woman. So I'm not even gonna argue with the men who think that they have it hard. They even brought sports back for those men. Yeah, where's the women's sports? Uh-huh. Do you know, I'm just feeling all of you right now, and if you are just tits up or down, or what's that saying? Tits somewhere.
Tits to the sky?
Tits to...
We wish.
Is that dead? My tits are between my legs because it's so they're so tired.
If your tits are tired, it's time for this to be over.
Happy Mom Truth Friday. You're not alone. Join the club. I have like zero advice for you other than
the springs on these trampolines are dead.
You
springs have tits to the sky.
Yeah.
Cheers.